From Nature's Fair Markets in Kelowna, BC, naturesfair.tv presents Beautiful Skin Begins Within with Lorna Vanderhaeghe. Now, here's your host for the evening, Karen Marquardt.
So thrilled to have you here on this wonderful September evening, joining us for our special guest presentation. We're so lucky to have Lorna Vanderhaeghe here. She is Canada's leading women's health expert. And as such, she's been researching nutritional medicine for over 30 years. With she's degrees in biochemistry and master's in nutrition, she's the author of 11 books, including A Smart Woman's Guide to Hormones and A Smart Woman's Guide to Weight Loss. So please help me welcome our guest speaker tonight, Lorna Vanderhaeghe.
Thank you so much. And obviously, we want to learn a lot about our skin because we have another big crowd here at Nature's Fair. And you've been sitting here looking at the screen, which is focusing on all the different statistics in regards to skin health. And tonight I'm going to talk to you about everything from eczema to psoriasis to wrinkles to dry skin, and basically just how to have beautiful skin from the time we're born until we die, which is completely possible. The other thing is we're spending billions of dollars on cosmetic treatments in Canada today. Not millions, but billions. And this is the first time in history that we have more women over the age of 50 than under. And of course, we want to look great. And we want to look great well into our 90s, and we can. So we're going to talk about how we can do that. And I used to talk only about nutrition. When I first got my nutrition degree, I was so excited. I wanted to go out there and teach people that we could fix everything that ails us with the food that we eat. And the sad thing is it's really hard to change the way we eat. The way our mom taught us to eat when we were little is the way we continue to eat as we get older. And sometimes the guys are lucky because they're going to go eat at another mother's house, basically. And that may be a good or a bad thing. But when it comes to our skin, food is really our medicine. And whenever I hear a skin doctor or, you know, you take a child to the doctor to have their acne looked at and the doctor says, oh, you know, the food you eat doesn't have any effect on your skin. That can't be, because you have to understand that your skin is an extension of the tube that goes from your mouth to your butt. So what's going on inside your body is going to show up on your skin. And so the foods you eat and whether or not your digestive tract is working properly is going to determine whether or not you have beautiful skin or you have skin with some health issues. Super skin foods are dark colored vegetables, dark colored fruits, particularly blueberries. You want to have good fats, and you also, so fish is a good one. You want lots of good clean sources of protein. So that's where we go free range, wild and organic whenever we can. And we really want to eat a lot of vegetables. That's the key to beautiful glowing skin. The reason is if you eat 5 servings of vegetables a day, you're not going to get constipated because you're going to have lots of fiber, which means that things will move through your digestive tract better, and that will be much better for your skin ultimately. We have so much confusion about fat. Every time I hear someone recommending low-fat, no-fat diets, I think, oh no, we're going to see dry skin, sagging skin, our brain doesn't function well. And so low-fat, no-fat diets are literally killing us. We don't think clearly, and it's bad for our skin. But we have to have the right kind of fats because most of us are eating too many of the bad fats. So the right kind of fats are extra virgin olive oil, organic coconut butter, and I love Omega Nutrition's coconut butter. It's just fantastic. And the little blue flower that you see in the middle of the screen, that little blue flower is the borage flower. And we hear so much about fish oil and flaxseed oil and all the other oils, and we hear very little about borage oil. And that's a sad thing because borage oil is the beautiful skin oil. It is the oil that gives us GLA. And I'm going to talk about GLA a lot tonight because it is the key to gorgeous skin. And so these are the good fats, nuts and seeds, extra virgin olive oil. you need to go home and start reading labels. You know, canola is genetically modified rapeseed. We don't want to eat that oil. We don't want to have processed oils in our fridge or in our cupboards. We want to eat the cold-pressed, healthy oils for beautiful skin. And of course, we eat a lot of these foods. And the challenge when we eat a lot of these things, well, we really shouldn't even call them foods, is they mess up our digestive tract. They also, I really think there should be a big warning sign in front of a lot of the fast food restaurants saying, if you eat here often enough, you will get heart disease and diabetes. Maybe then we might think twice before we drive through the fast food restaurants. So the skin is made up of different layers. And you know, we get cellulite, we have acne, we have wrinkling that goes on. And when a baby is born, they have this beautiful, smooth skin. And we all want to touch that skin. It's amazing. You know, you see a newborn, people always want to touch their skin because it's so absolutely gorgeous. Well, the reason why a newborn skin is so beautiful is that babies are made up of predominantly collagen. And they have lots and lots of collagen, which give them this beautiful, smooth skin. And as we age, our collagen levels decline. Now, I'm here to tell you they don't have to decline. We actually have enough science now to know that we can keep collagen levels at a healthy level if we do the right things with nutrition, food, and also lifestyle factors. So you want to have nice, healthy skin so that you don't see all of the skin problems. Eczema, psoriasis, dermatitis, these are all telling you that there's something not right in your body, whether there's a deficiency, your digestive tract isn't working well, or something to that effect. So why do we wrinkle? And although this woman is a beautiful woman, none of us want to look like her. We don't want to have these deep wrinkles. We don't want to have dry skin. And so there's lots of reasons why we wrinkle. The number one reason is inflammation. Now, when you think about inflammation, you think about sore joints and arthritis. That's inflammation that you can feel. But inflammation is the immune system's response to different things in the body. For example, when you get a cold, your immune system creates lots of inflammation to get rid of the cold. And when you have arthritis, your body creates lots of inflammation to tell you to sit down, put up your foot, don't put too much pressure on there because we're creating damage. When we look at inflammation in the skin, it causes redness, rashes, and wrinkling. So we want to calm that inflammation down in the body, especially if we have something like psoriasis or dermatitis or rosacea or eczema. The second thing that causes us to wrinkle is collagen decline, and I'm going to talk a lot about collagen and how we can rebuild it tonight. Loss of elasticity. You know, as we get older, we notice everything starts heading to the floor. So, you know, our chin is heading to our breasts are heading to our waist, the sagging skin under our arms. All of a sudden, you notice that the knees are getting a little baggier. That's everything heading south because you're losing collagen and elasticity in the skin. So we're going to talk about how to fix that too. Sun damage is an issue. I don't think it's as big an issue as the sunscreen manufacturers are making it out to be, because we do need a little bit of sunshine on our skin to make vitamin D. Lack of moisture in the skin is also another reason for wrinkling. Fatty acid deficiencies, and I'm going to talk about fatty acids and how important they are to having beautiful glowing skin. Not enough nutrients. So this is when you're simply nutrient deficient. And genetics are at the bottom of the list, because the great thing about genetics is you can be given certain genes that may make you have varicose veins or wrinkling that's earlier than other women. But the great thing is you can turn those genes off if you want to. You just need to know what to do to actually make that happen. Skin tags. I think skin tags are one of the most dangerous warning signs on the body. So these are these little white fleshy growths that we get. Some women pull them off with tweezers. I noticed they have this new thing on TV, the skin tag remover. I really think that underneath that ad for the skin tag remover, it should have a warning that goes across the bottom that says, If you have four skin tags or more, you're a pre-diabetic. And diabetics are covered in skin tags. Anybody who's got type 2 diabetes bad will tell you they've got lots of them. And they're one of the earliest warning signs that your blood sugar is out of balance. So how do we fix that? We eat more protein. So you start your day with protein. That's an egg, a chicken breast, a protein shake, protein powder in yogurt. But you want to start your day with protein. You want to have a piece of protein the size of the palm of your hand at every meal, and lots of dark colored vegetables. That will balance out your blood sugar. You never want to go more than 3 hours without eating something. So you want to have a healthy snack. You know, the worst thing is to get up. 50% of women do not eat breakfast. We have coffee or tea, and that's what we classify as food. And so when that happens, it causes disruption in our blood sugar. So we want to get up, eat protein. We want to have snacks throughout the day that are healthy snacks to keep that blood sugar balanced. We can also use a product called GlucoSmart, which balances our blood sugar. And in the studies, they found when they had people who had abnormal blood sugar get their blood sugar balanced, their skin tags fell off. So literally fell off the body once the blood sugar was balanced. So if you've got skin tags, that's a warning sign that your blood sugar is out of balance and that you are heading on the route to diabetes. The other great thing about the GlucoSmart is it works for busting belly fat also. Menopause and skin health. Why is it that all of a sudden our periods stop and our skin starts looking so bad? I mean, some women age dramatically in the first year after menopause. And I thought, there's got to be a reason to this. It can't just simply be because our hormones have fluctuated. And so I started doing research for this. I'm writing a book with Dr. Martin Braun in Vancouver. He's a medical doctor, called Beautiful Skin Begins Within. And so I started to do research why we see such dramatic shifts in our skin at menopause. We see big shifts in the skin when we're teenagers because our hormones are changing. Then we see it happen again at menopause when the periods stop. Two very bad things happen to us. The first thing is we no longer can make GLA from our food. So GLA is that very special fatty acid I was talking about earlier that we can get from the borage plant. But when we go through menopause, the body is no longer able to make GLA from our food. The only human source of GLA is breast milk. So that's the only food source for GLA. And of course, we're not going to breastfeed until we're 50. So as a result, it's hard to get GLA. Otherwise, you have to make GLA from the food you eat. But when you go through menopause, an enzyme that allows us to make GLA becomes defective. This is the reason why our skin gets so dry and dull and flat looking. So all of a sudden, you notice that your skin lacks that luster and it's much drier than it used to be. Also, GLA is a very powerful anti-inflammatory in the skin, so we get more rashes and itchy skin and rosacea flare-ups as a result of it. The other thing that happens at menopause is we can lose up to 30% of our collagen in the first few years after menopause. And some women lose 30% of their collagen in the first year. So they will see a dramatic decline in the way their skin looks. Everything starts to sag because you've now lost the cushion in your skin. And so we can fix that, and we're going to talk about how to do that. Another thing that happens is age spots. And that's because the skin cells don't turn over as quickly as they did when you were younger. And we can solve that problem by taking antioxidants, things like vitamin A, vitamin E, vitamin C, which you find in a good multivitamin, lipoic acid, coenzyme Q10. These are the skin superstar antioxidants to stop us from getting all these brown spots that we see. So let's talk about GLA, because I think it is the key to beautiful skin. GLA is not found in fish oil. It is not found in flaxseed oil. The only food that we can get GLA in is breast milk. So once you stop being breastfed, you have to make it in your body. And we can do that quite effectively. Most people are good at making GLA, except those people who get eczema, psoriasis, dermatitis, rosacea. Those people are all deficient in GLA. The earliest warning sign that you're deficient in GLA is when a baby is born and develops cradle cap. Cradle cap is the first sign that a child is deficient in GLA. And GLA is very important for brain function as well. We often see kids that have severe cradle cap develop ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, because they were so GLA deficient. So that's the earliest warning sign that you're GLA deficient. And it's really easy to fix because we just give people GLA supplements. How much GLA would you take a day? If you were going to take a GLA supplement, you would take 2 teaspoons a day, would be sort of a maintenance dose. If you have psoriasis, you would take much more. You could even take up to 2 tablespoons a day. And the great thing about GLA is that you can eat it and you can also put it on the skin. So you might notice if you're buying very expensive cosmetics that some of them contain GLA already. The cosmetic industry has been using GLA in a lot of its skin creams for a very long time for this issue. Remember, you want to limit the amount of bad fats that you consume. So margarine, canola oil, soy oil, corn oil, peanut oil. These are oils you just shouldn't have in your house. And in order to make GLA from your food when you're younger, nuts and seeds are a source, so are dark colored vegetables, which is the reason why we keep telling people to eat their greens. Eat lots and lots of dark colored veggies. So GLA is very important for healthy skin. Another thing that's so great about GLA is that it's been researched for breast cancer treatment. So they have given women who are on tamoxifen, which is a drug for a chemotherapy drug for breast cancer, and they have given them GLA along with the tamoxifen and found that it made the drug work better. So it's safe for women who have breast cancer. It also has been researched for painful periods. So anyone who has painful periods, whether you're 13 or 45, will use GLA for that as well. And it works for breast pain. So anyone who's getting breast pain also needs GLA. But it truly is the beautiful skin oil, and it makes your skin glow, and it works quickly. So I always tell people to do the GLA challenge, where you drink an entire bottle of GLA in 10 days, and that's about 2 tablespoons a day, and then you go down to the 2 teaspoon a day dose. And if you don't like the taste of it, you can always buy it in capsules. We have it in capsules too. But I love the oil because you can eat it and you can put it on your skin. I use it as an under eye wrinkle cream when I go to bed. For those babies who have cradle cap, we actually massage the GLA skin oil right into the cradle cap. If you have eczema, you can apply it topically as well. Same with psoriasis and rosacea. So I want to talk to you about the Selegrin cream because they did some very good research using this particular ingredient, which is a natural fatty acid. And what they discovered is Selegrin was originally designed as a treatment for arthritis. And they developed a cream and they went to the University of Connecticut and they had people apply the Selegrin cream to their knees morning and night. And this particular study was done right next to a nunnery, so they had a lot of nuns taking part in the study. And at the end of the study, people had to fill out all these questionnaires throughout the entire study, and they had a placebo group using fake cream, and then they had the treatment group using the Selegrin cream. And the funny thing was, all these women were writing that the wrinkles on their knees were disappearing through the study. And the researchers went, we really should pay attention to this because the majority of the participants were nuns and they knew they weren't lying. And so this arthritis product, and often, you know, products come out of some other research, this arthritis product called Selegrin, they then went to the University of California and they did a study looking at Selegrin for wrinkles, and they found great results using Selegrin topically to reduce wrinkles, and they came up with a 10% Selegrin concentration for wrinkles, which is what you tried in the cream that we passed around. And then they went on to do research with psoriasis sufferers. Now, anybody who has psoriasis knows it is one of the most challenging conditions to treat, and the drugs are nasty and don't often give relief. And what they found in this study, they had took people who had failed all the drug treatments for topical treatments and oral treatments for psoriasis. They had them apply the Selegin cream morning and night, and then they tested the skin scaliness, the depth of the lesions. People with psoriasis can get lots of white flakes on their skin, and they can end up with these thick layers of skin because the skin just keeps laying down new layer, new layer, new layer on top of the old layers of skin, and it doesn't shed off properly. And what they found by day 14, now this was in a group of people who nothing worked. They found that the skin was softer, that the psoriasis was going in remission, it was clearing up, the skin wasn't as red, it was moister, and the participants were really quite happy. And this was using the topical Selegin cream. The wrinkle study I already told you about, these were women ages 25 to 65. They use a very sophisticated camera to measure the depth of wrinkles when they do wrinkle studies on the skin. And they actually measure the skin of the upper arm so that it's not so affected by the topicals that we use. So they use that as a base layer. Then they also measure the depth of the wrinkles on the skin of the face. And I can tell you, if you want to do a little test, because whenever I'm checking to see if research actually works, what I did was apply the Selegin cream to one half of my face. And my friends are used to me doing these strange things. So my best friend that I've had since I was 16, about 6 weeks into my little study, she said, "What are you doing to one half of your face?" And I said, "Do you see a difference?" And she said, "You should do it to the other side too." So it does work. It works. It works. It's very inexpensive. It's a great cream. My best friend also owns a jewelry store, and she started recommending it for people because she said women would come in and they'd buy rings, and they couldn't get their rings over their big knuckles. And that's one of the earliest warning signs of arthritis. And she noticed that when you apply it morning and night and you're using your hands to apply it, and she would rub the extras into her hands, that the big knuckles were starting to shrink. So she probably sells more Selegin than a health food store because she's telling women you need to shrink those big knuckles on your hands, which it does very well doing that. Eczema. Look at this mess on the back of this person's knees. The reason why I am interested or involved in the health food industry today is because my oldest daughter, who's now 35, when I stopped breastfeeding her, she developed eczema from head to toe. And she had the worst mess. We went from doctor to doctor to pediatrician to skin specialist, whose only solution was cortisone creams. And I read the cortisone cream side effects, which is thinning skin and all kinds of horrible hormone problems, and I didn't want to use this on my one-year-old. And so I went into a health food store for the very first time with this baby, and the woman in the store said, "Your baby has an essential fatty acid deficiency," and we put her on GLA. And within weeks, this awful, weeping, cracking, red, itchy mess was gone, and I was completely converted. I thought, there's something to this nutritional medicine over here. I went back to school and learned more about it because I was so amazed that the medical doctors knew nothing about GLA, and in a very short period of time, this horrible mess was gone. So up to 25% of children develop eczema, and about 15% of adults have it at any one time. It is solely a GLA deficiency. So the reason why you develop it is because you do not make GLA from your food effectively. So a lot of kids with the cradle cap will get eczema as they get older as well. So allergies can make it worse. So often allergies to oranges and tomatoes, wheat and dairy can also make it worse. But once we build up the GLA levels in the skin, then people can tend to eat those foods that used to make their eczema worse. And the great thing about the GLA is it works topically. Now, if you've got a two-year-old that's covered in eczema, don't slather their whole body in GLA. You want to try a little spot to make sure that they don't have a reaction before you do it on the whole body. and then put it in their food. So with my daughter, what we did, we put GLA in her food, and then I rubbed it on the spots on her body and before she went to bed and put her in a sleeper. Remember, it's oil, so it'll make your clothes oily if you're going to put it on during the day. And then we have the dosages on the screen here. So for a child under 50 pounds, you'd use 1,000 milligrams a day. And for adults, you can use lots. So the more you use, the faster the eczema will go into remission. So we have some people that it works, two teaspoons a day works quite well, and other people have to use 2 tablespoons a day. Rosacea. This is a very common condition. We're seeing a lot more of it as people age. And it tends to get very, very bad after you've gone through menopause. It's worse with hot flashes. These are the people that'll have a couple of glasses of wine and their face goes bright red. Sometimes rosacea, people think it will be acne, but it's not. It's a thickening of the skin. So Bill Clinton has rosacea. He doesn't have that, he wasn't born with that big bulbous nose. The problem with rosacea is that if you do not treat it, it disfigures your skin. So you can end up with thickenings of your on your cheeks and your chin, your nose, and often right here in the center of the forehead, you get like pimple or whitehead outbreaks. The doctors treat it with antibiotics. So they generally use topical antibiotics or oral antibiotics for it. The way we treat it is a vascular condition, so it affects the little capillaries in the skin, and it is an inflammatory condition. So we want to calm down the inflammation in the skin, and we do that using GLA, lots of GLA, as well as using Celadrin. So you can use the Celadrin cream topically. You can also take Celadrin capsules orally and use the GLA. And I had a gentleman at one of my talks like this, doing a beautiful skin talk, and he said, look at my rosacea. And he said, if I have one beer, this just flares up, and for 3 days it will look awful. So he started the program. He said, is this stuff for me too? And I said, yes, all of these skin recommendations are for men and women. And he started the topical Celadrin cream, the GLA oil, and the Celadrin capsules. And he contacted me not too long after that to say, is completely in remission. And he said, I can even have a beer now, and my skin doesn't flare up. So we can put these things into remission. Some women get it really bad when they're pregnant as well. It'll really flare up during pregnancy. So let's talk about how to build collagen. That's really what we want to know how to do. And we want to build collagen from a young age. Although we can solve a lot of the collagen problems, even if you've already got deep wrinkles later, let's start younger. Like my little granddaughters are already taking collagen-enhancing supplements when they're young. And they've been on GLA since their moms were pregnant, because we want to have beautiful, glowing skin throughout our life. And collagen, the other issue you have to know about collagen, although when we start to lose collagen, you see it in your face. You know, you get those deep lines here. You start to get everything sagging, the hollows in your cheeks. Your neck starts to start hanging. That's collagen decline, but collagen is the glue that makes your bones strong. So if you're losing collagen in your face, you are losing collagen in your bones. And that is the reason why women get such dramatic bone loss after menopause. It's because they're losing collagen. And then they lose bone along with it. Collagen also makes your fingernails hard and your hair elastic and strong and grow faster. So the ways that we build collagen, we have a couple of ways to do it. One, we use salicylic acid and biotin, which is found in Collagen Plus. And this will get your body building collagen. And it does it from the inside. So this is to get your body making the collagen it should be making. And we can start taking this very, very young. Collagen Plus is a liquid. You add it to juice, coffee, tea, wine, whatever you want to, any kind of liquid, and 10 drops a day. They also did research using salicylic acid for osteoporosis, pre-osteoporosis. So this was, they showed that they could increase bone density and bone strength using this nutrient as well. Most women will buy it because it makes your hair get thicker and stronger and grow faster, makes your fingernails hard, and also helps to reduce the depth of wrinkles. But I personally think Collagen Plus is the greatest bone supplement on the planet. So if you're buying it for your skin, you're going to get the added bone building benefits. And you can start taking this young. It also, when we get stretch marks, that's because the collagen layer in our skin has torn. So you can use this when you're pregnant to ensure that you don't get stretch marks also. And when you've got teenagers that are growing rapidly, they also could take Collagen Plus to keep that base layer in their skin, the integrity of it, nice and hard or stronger. Active collagen. We can also take collagen supplements. Now, when I first started writing the Beautiful Skin book, I looked at all the different kinds of collagen, and there are lots of different types of collagen. There's chicken type 2 collagen, which is for your joints. There are 16 different types of collagen in the body, so you have to use the right kind of collagen for skin. For example, if you took chicken type 2 collagen, that's going to make you have healthy tendons and joints, but it's not going to do anything for beautiful skin. And so I started to look at all the supplements that were sold that had collagen in them. And most of them come from slaughterhouse waste. So pig parts, cow parts, some of them they boil up the cow hides and the hoofs and all the leftover bits to make this gelatinous goo, which is collagen. And I didn't want to take any of those. And there was no science behind any of them. There was no studies telling us that these things worked. So I started doing research and found a manufacturer in France that was making a fish collagen and elastin polypeptide product that they had great research. And so the research study, this is the research study, they took 43 women. They've done a bunch of studies, but this was their first one. They took 43 women between the ages of 40 and 55 who had deep crow's feet wrinkles at the side of their face, and they measured the depth of the wrinkles before they started the study. They gave them 2,000 milligrams of active collagen, and at day 28, they measured the depth of the wrinkles, and they found up to a 30% reduction in the depth of deep wrinkles. By day 84, the skin was moister, it was much tighter, and the wrinkles continue to improve over time. And this is a hydrolyzed fish marine collagen and elastin polypeptide. And it works, it works, it works. Because the research is so good, we are allowed to put on our label for the reduction of the depth of deep wrinkles. Nothing says that. It's always fine lines and wrinkles. And I love this product. I wish I would have known about this product when I was 20 to make sure that those wrinkles didn't get deeper. So we're hoping they'll totally reverse over time. They actually measured the depth, and you can start to see a difference. I always tell people, if you're going to use this product, take a photo of your wrinkles before you start, because as it improves, you forget what you used to look like. Now I'm going to talk to you about hormones as well. We have several different types of estrogen supplements. The only estrogen that is safe is estriol. And the reason why we know estriol is safe, first off, estriol is the estrogen made by your body when you're pregnant to protect your baby from the bad estrogens, the ones that are aggressive. Estriol is so safe, they've done 18 clinical trials looking at using estriol for wrinkles and for reversing male facial hair growth in women. So a lot of women who get whiskers on their upper lip and their chin can use estriol topically. Now, estriol is a drug. It's a prescription drug. It is made up at a compounding pharmacy. So if you go to the doctor and you get a prescription for estriol, you would take it to a compounding pharmacy and they would make it in a topical solution for your skin. And your doctor is not going to give you a prescription for estriol for skin. He will or she will give you a prescription for vaginal dryness. So 9 times out of 10, they won't even check, so because they're too busy. So just tell them, I have vaginal dryness, I want estriol. They'll write you a prescription, then go to the compounder and say, I'm actually going to use it on my face. and it is fantastic for women who have male facial hair growth, but it's also good for the skin of the vagina. And remember, that's still skin. And when we start to have thinning of the vaginal wall, painful intercourse, as well as recurring urinary tract infections, that's because our estrogen levels in the urovaginal area have started to decline. And we can quickly fix that by using estriol vaginally. Most doctors prescribe Vagifem, Premarin. If you go and read the warnings for those, it's breast cancer, abnormal cell growth in the uterus. If you use estriol, you will never have abnormal cell growth. They know this from the safety studies that have been done. It will never cause a thick uterine lining, and it will never cause breast cancer. So if you're in the room and you're already using Vagifem, Premarin cream, then you want to go to your doctor and switch to the estriol. And then you put a little bit down there and a little bit on your wrinkles, because it works so well for wrinkles. They actually found it made the skin thicken up again, just like when you were younger and had more density to your skin. And the prescription is 0.5 milligrams. And in my Smart Woman's Guide to Hormones book, we have all the prescriptions for bioidentical hormones in case your doctor does not know how to write a prescription for them. So you can write that down. Age spots, that's those, we call them liver spots, brown spots on the back of our hands. Some women get brown spots as a result of hormones. Some women get them when they go on the birth control pill. All of a sudden they'll be developing, you know, brown spots on the face and the cheeks. That's caused by progesterone. So, and too much progesterone cream and too much progesterone in pill form can also cause brown spots on the skin. That's why I always tell people, if you're going to use bioidentical hormones, make sure you're working with someone who knows what they're doing. Otherwise, you could end up with a bigger problem. The other things that cause brown spots on the skin is excessive sun and not enough antioxidants to cause proper cell turnover. So this is where the sun becomes your enemy, because you aren't taking enough antioxidants in your food. If you had more antioxidants, then your skin would turn over quicker and you wouldn't develop these brown spots. How do we treat them? Well, you can have IPL laser, which will get rid of them, but it's expensive and you need multiple treatments to do it. And so I did a little experiment. I did IPL on one hand and I used sulforaphane ointment on the other. And sulforaphane ointment is available from Nuco. They make it. Little tiny bottle. Lasts about 2 years, lasts forever. I still try to get to the bottom of it. And I use it twice a day. It takes quite a long time. So you first start putting it on, it's one of those things where you think, this isn't going to work. And then all of a sudden you notice that the brown spot gets lighter and starts to spread out. And then it gets bigger and bigger and bigger until it completely disappears. So that's a topical treatment called sulforaphane ointment. They also have a cream. Don't buy the cream. It doesn't work. The ointment works, and it works for all kinds of discolorations on the skin. And so I used one hand had IPL, and the other hand I used the sulforaphane ointment, and they both work very, very well. One was more expensive, and one was much, much cheaper. So it depends on how dedicated you are to using the topical every day. And then increase your antioxidants. That's vitamins A, C, E, selenium, and zinc, which you're going to find in a multivitamin. And Celeste demoed lots of things before the talk, so if you didn't try the multivitamin, all those things before the talk, you can try them when we're finished the talk as well. Varicose veins. Nobody wants to have veins that look like this. And you don't have to. And in Europe, if you went to a doctor in Europe with your varicose veins, they would prescribe a drug that contains all the ingredients in my VeinSmart product. So here in Canada, all the ingredients are sold over the counter, but in Europe it would be a prescription. And varicose veins, the uglier they are, the faster VeinSmart works. So take a photo of your varicose veins, again, so you can show the change. And even if you're having varicose veins treatments at the cosmetic doc's office, you still want to take VeinSmart so you don't have to worry about them coming back or showing up elsewhere. I have one friend who spends a lot of money getting her varicose veins lasered, and she said it's like one disappears and a new one pops up. And I keep telling her, if you took the VeinSmart along with your varicose vein treatment, you would not be continually having these veins come back. Hemorrhoids are a varicose vein in the anus. So if you've got hemorrhoids, they're a varicose vein as well, and VeinSmart works exceptionally well to get rid of hemorrhoids. If you have spider veins, the VeinSmart takes much longer to treat spider veins than it does the big, gnarly varicose vein. So the uglier the vein, the faster it works. You also want to make sure you eat lots of vegetables, dark-colored vegetables, and dark-colored berries, because we want to get the wall of your veins to be stronger. The reason why you end up with this mess of a vein system is because the walls are weakened, and then the force of the blood going back to your heart causes them to become disfigured. So lots and lots of veggies, put your legs up, take VeinSmart, and if you ever massage your legs, don't massage down. If you put cream on your legs, you have to start at your ankle and work your way up. Don't go backwards. It's very important, especially if you're doing cellulite treatments. You start at the ankle and you work your way up the body. Acne, another really big skin problem. We don't just see acne in teenagers. We see it in 40-year-olds as well, and some menopausal women even get acne. Why are we getting acne? In teenagers, what's happening is when you go to ovulate or pop out an egg, because of all the environmental hormones that we're exposed to in our water and our food, our environment, the egg is not being popped out properly, and so the body sends out lots of testosterone and other male hormones. And when that happens, you end up with acne. What is the doctor's solution for acne? The birth control pill. So today we have the largest number ever of teenagers taking the birth control pill, not for contraception, but for acne. And we have 1 in 6 women today who cannot get pregnant. And I think a lot of it is that we're putting 15-year-olds on the pill to treat their acne. They're not coming off until they're 31, and they're not ovulating properly. So it's not a good way to treat acne. The way we treat acne is to get the body ovulating properly, and then the acne disappears. And we use EstroSmart to do that. So EstroSmart is a girl's best friend, contains plant nutrients that get your hormones balanced, and the acne disappears in 60 days. So 2 full menstrual cycles using 2 to 4 capsules a day. When you hit the right dose, the acne literally disappears. The reason why we see acne in the 40-year-old crowd is because as they head towards menopause, some months we ovulate and some months we don't. And on the months you don't ovulate, you'll get pimple outbreaks. We'll see this in a lot of 52-year-old women. All of a sudden, you may have irregular periods as you're getting closer to menopause, and now you're getting male facial hair growth, acne, vaginal dryness, hot flash. All these things start happening to us. Celeste and I were commenting before the talk started that all these things that happen to us, it's a lot of work to keep this body functioning and happy with all of our hormones changing all the time. But I don't think that the birth control pill is the solution for acne, and I think it's a real shame that we have so many young women on the pill today to treat acne, when we can use something like EstroSmart and GLA to get the hormones back into balance. I also wanted to let you know, a lot of skin products have milk thistle in them. And please be careful, because the Cancer Society sent out a warning about the daily use of milk thistle and increased risk of breast cancer and elevated prolactin in the body. So Milk thistle is a wonderful herb, don't get me wrong, but it is designed to be taken for a liver cleanse, 7 to 14 days. We're seeing milk thistle in a lot of supplements that you're taking every single day. And now that this new research is out showing that when milk thistle is taken on a daily basis by women, it disrupts prolactin levels, I think women should be aware of that. So go home and read your labels and make sure that you're not taking a supplement that has milk thistle in it every day. It's designed for a liver cleanse that you do a few times a year. This is my website, hormonehelp.com. Go there. We have amazing information on the site. There's thousands of pages of information. We have free books like Get a Grip on Arthritis and A to Z Woman's Guide to Vibrant Health, your 30-day Heart Smart Solution, and also lots of lectures and talks and just so much information to help you navigate all of our different issues that we have happen. We're going to do question and answer period. And so if you have a question, put up your hand. I'll repeat the question back so that you guys can tape it. Yes. Okay, the question is warts. What do we do for warts? Well, warts are a virus. So first thing it tells me is that the immune system is not working very well. So if it's a child that, is it a child? Somebody who's younger? If it's a child that has warts, I give them chewable Modicare. And that's to get their immune system working better. If it's an adult with warts, then definitely you want to get the immune system working better. We use ImmunoSmart to do that. And we have to be very leery of warts as women because we end up with the virus from warts is the HPV virus. And you do not want to have that end up on your cervix. So warts are contagious. They should be treated. One of the best treatments for warts is duct tape. So what you do is you get an emery board and you rub the wart till you've aggravated it and then put a piece of duct tape around it. Why does it work? It works because all of a sudden you've aggravated it, you've put the duct tape on there, now your immune system can find the wart. And then you take ImmunoSmart if you're an adult and Modicare chewables if you're a child. So it's a good question, thank you. Yes, at the back. Oh, for cellulite. Yes, I wondered where my cellulite slide went, and then I forgot to mention it. So for cellulite, the treatment is, the reason why we get cellulite is elevated estrogen levels. So a lot of women will all of a sudden see that they develop cellulite around 39, 40, 41, and you do not have to be overweight to develop cellulite. Cellulite is just as prevalent in thin women as overweight women. It is caused because your estrogen levels are overloaded. So we put you on EstroSmart to bring your estrogen in the normal range. The way EstroSmart works, brings your progesterone up and brings your estrogen in the normal range. If it's too high, it brings it down. If it's too low, it brings it up. So you go on EstroSmart, 2 capsules a day, and then massage is fantastic for getting the cellulite to start smoothing, to smooth the skin out. So you want to start at the tips of your toes and up your leg, right? And the other thing that's fantastic for cellulite is rebounding. So buy yourself a little rebounder. You can buy them on the in the fitness stores, on the home shopping channel. And 10 minutes of rebounding a day will get the lymph moving in your skin. The reason why you get cellulite is because the fat and the fluid start to stretch the skin apart. And so you end up with this orange peel look. And the reason is because the lymph, which is the fluid, only moves in the body when you do. So if you sit, it stagnates. So what you want to do is buy yourself a rebounder. They're not expensive. They look like a little trampoline. Plump it in front of your TV. And 10 minutes of rebounding a day is equivalent to 30 minutes of walking. And you can put your Velcro weights on, which will be good for preventing osteoporosis as well. So, good question. The only topicals that work for cellulite are caffeine-based. So topical caffeine works very well for that.
What do you suggest for dry eyes?
Okay, what do I suggest for dry eyes? You need to eat lots of GLA. So remember, all these mucous membranes in the body, including your vagina, inside your mouth, in your eyes, we want to get our GLA levels up because then we get moisture in our skin. You know, we're very big on putting things on topically on the skin or drops in the eyes. Let's rebuild our moisture content from the inside. So you want to take GLA by the spoonful. Works very well for that. Yes?
Okay, with the GLA, and you said up to 2 tablespoons a day, is that 2 tablespoons at once? Should you spread it out?
The question is, do you spread out the GLA supplements throughout the day or do you take it all at once? You can take it all at once. You know, I'm a big fan of making things simple because what we often do is buy things and for the first 3 days we're really good at taking it and then we stop. So you have to put those supplements in the middle of your kitchen counter. Put them where you're going to use them. Put them in the middle of the dinner table. Don't move them. Leave them there. They'll stare at you to take them. So make it easy, whatever works for you. In my house, I add the GLA to spaghetti sauce. I add it after we've cooked it. I add it to that. I make salad dressing out of it. And make sure you clean the bowl because, you know, it's expensive salad dressing. And, you know, you can put it in all kinds of foods, shakes. We also have started developing a lot of our products in powders and liquids because as we get older, it's harder to swallow pills. So it makes life a lot easier for us to get those things down. Yes. EstroSmart should be used by every woman from the time she starts menstruating until she dies. EstroSmart's also the ingredients stop abnormal cell growth in the breast. We use it for uterine fibroids, for breast lumps, ovarian cysts. I think it is probably one of the best things for preventing breast cancer. So we should start it very young. We have lots of little girls with precocious puberty. So this is 8, 9, and 10-year-olds that are getting periods and breast buds and pubic hair. And they used to think this was because our nutrition was better. They now know this is not a good thing, that those girls tend to develop type 2 diabetes earlier. And so we have lots of those very young girls on EstroSmart at 8 years old. 2 capsules a day would be enough. And we had one really smart mom whose daughter could not swallow pills yet. And so she said the only thing she could find to mask the flavor was dark chocolate pudding. So she mixed it in that for her daughter. Yes.
Dripping nose.
Pardon?
Dripping nose.
Dripping nose, yes. That's called rhinitis. And it's an inflammation in the nose, and the way we treat it is with ImmunoSmart. Works very well to get your immune system calmed down and the dripping nose stops. And it's a big problem, and we see it. You know, my grandmother always had Kleenex stuffed up her sweater. But she had chronic rhinitis. She really needed an immune system support nutrient. Yes. Okay. Oh, this is a very good question. So this woman is taking magnesium bisglycinate for her leg cramps at night. Works very well for that. And she said she noticed that it also can lower blood pressure. It only lowers blood pressure in people with high blood pressure. If you have low blood pressure or normal blood pressure, it's not going to do a thing for it. So, yeah.
What is the difference between
that and MagSmart? Yes. So the question is, what is the difference between MagSmart and magnesium bisglycinate? Well, magnesium bisglycinate in our catalog is just magnesium. Nothing else in the capsule comes in a capsule. The, The MagSmart is magnesium bisglycinate with taurine and malic acid and other things, and that's for fibromyalgia and for muscle pain and for sleeping, for high blood pressure and leg cramps and restless legs and twitchy eyebrows. That's the powder. Yes. Yeah, so that's the difference. Yes. Okay, thyroid problems. What do we do for thyroid problems? We have an epidemic of low thyroid in Canada today. People need, when they go to get tested, when you go to have a thyroid test, it's called a TSH, you need copies of your blood test, and you need to read the number. Your TSH in BC, the normal range is 0.5 to 5.5. So the doctor will not classify you as low thyroid till you're above 5.5. But we know anyone with a TSH above 2 will start having symptoms. By the time you get to 5.5, your hair is falling out, you've gained 40 pounds, you have no sex drive, you've gained weight, you're cold all the time, you feel lethargic. None of that is a good thing. So you want to first find out your number. If you are not bad enough yet to get drugs, we use ThyroSmart. And you take 2 capsules at breakfast. It's very, very safe. You can eat bottlefuls of it and never cause hyperthyroid. So 2 ThyroSmart at breakfast. If you're already on thyroid medication, it's not working so well for you, you stay on your thyroid medication. You take it first thing in the morning on an empty stomach. And then you take 2 ThyroSmart with breakfast. That's to get your thyroid converting T4 to T3, which is the more potent and active thyroid hormone. Okay. I always get this question, can you get off the medication? And what we have found over the last 10 years of recommending ThyroSmart, I've only had one person successfully get off their medication. But most people end up taking the absolute lowest dose of medication and getting fantastic results when they combine ThyroSmart with it. The one challenge with thyroid medication is that over time, the doctor keeps prescribing higher and higher and higher doses, but you still aren't getting results. That's because you're not converting T4 to T3. So we can see your thyroid dosing from the doctor going down when you take ThyroSmart. So, yeah. I noticed another question, yeah.
Hot flashes and sleep.
Okay, what do we do for hot flashes? Well, first off, we have to remember that when we go through menopause, our adrenal glands are supposed to kick in and make our hormones for us. Women who have virtually no symptoms at menopause, they have great functioning adrenal glands. And so we want to love our adrenals. We can use adrenal support nutrients for that, and we have a product called AdrenaSmart exactly for that. And then for hot flashes, night sweats, mood swings, vaginal dryness, we use MenoSmart Plus and our Love Personal Lubricant. Because remember, if you've got vaginal dryness, we talked about estriol. I'll go back to the estriol slide. We use estriol, which we can use internally, and we use our Love Personal Lubricant to give us lots of nice lubrication. And Love is pH perfect. It feels exactly like the real thing. It even tastes good. Doesn't stain panties. It's very nice lubricant. Yes. Oh, sleep. I'm sorry. You wanted to go to sleep. We have like 4 ways to sleep. There are 4 ways to sleep. And so some people can use one way and they do really well, and some people need all 4. Depends on how bad your insomnia is. So I love melatonin. And there are 2 kinds of melatonin, by the way. There's synthetic melatonin, and then there's natural melatonin. Some people, when they take synthetic melatonin, get nightmares. Natural melatonin does not cause that. So in our Sleep Smart, it contains natural melatonin along with sleep herbs to knock you out. Okay? Try that. Then we have our Melatonin Plus, which is a sublingual form which you put under the tongue. All the sublingual melatonins are synthetic. They're also for vegetarians because the natural melatonin comes from pigs. So The melatonin plus is just melatonin and B12. And that you put under your tongue. Some people that works for them. So you can pick which product you want to try. Then we use Mag Smart at bedtime to calm everything down so you don't have those muscles twitching. And then we also have some people who need Prometrium, which is a bioidentical natural progesterone that you take at bedtime. And that's a drug, a natural bioidentical progesterone. So we use those few things. And then for the people who fall asleep fine, but wake up several hours later wide awake and can't fall back to sleep, that's adrenal exhaustion. And those people take 2 AdrenaSmart at lunchtime to help them sleep at night. And don't exercise in the evening, don't drink coffee after lunchtime, and do not have dark chocolate at bedtime. They all keep you awake, right? So, sex is better in the morning, because before bed, it wakes us up. You know, your husband's out cold, but there you are, wide awake, right? Our cortisol levels go up. It's a terrible problem. So, yes. Okay, this is my favorite question of all. If you're estrogen positive breast cancer and you're also on tamoxifen, they're finished. Okay. Can you take EstroSmart? Every woman who wants to protect herself from breast cancer, has breast cancer, and never wants to get breast cancer again should go on EstroSmart. My personal mission is to have every woman on EstroSmart from the time she starts menstruating until she dies so we can do something about these terrible breast cancer rates and the ovarian cancer rates, all the hormone-related cancers. It also is great for men to help them keep their estrogen levels. You know, when our guys get a beer belly and breasts, it's because they're making too much estrogen. We need to give them EstroSmart as well to put it back into the normal range. And the way EstroSmart works is it stops your body from converting your healthy estrogen to the cancer-causing estrogen. So you definitely should take EstroSmart. Yeah.
Will that if I'm already taking progesterone?
Okay. If you're already on progesterone, this is a little unknown fact that doctors should tell women. Progesterone is used by your body to make cortisol, to make testosterone, and to make estrogen. So any woman on bioidentical hormones, meaning progesterone in your case, should also be taking EstroSmart. Why? Because we want to stop you from converting your progesterone into too much estrogen. Women who go on progesterone and get sore breasts, they're rapidly converting their progesterone to estrogen. Not a good thing. So we need to make sure that you're on EstroSmart when you're taking any bioidentical hormone. And you take EstroSmart if you're on the birth control pill, so that when you come off the pill, you will still have some fertility, right? The question is, we've been told that after menopause, women shouldn't take iron. And that people shouldn't take iron until they're tested. So the number one thing is we should be getting 20 milligrams of iron from our daily diet every day. According to the latest research, we're getting 8. And the reason why we're getting 8 milligrams is because most of us are not eating meat anymore. We're not eating as many eggs. And so the main sources of iron in our diet are red meat and egg yolks. And so as a result of that, we're seeing a huge decline in iron levels in people. And when you don't have enough iron, you can't think straight, your hair falls out. Low iron is the leading reason for hair loss in women. Your fingernails peel, you get dark circles under your eyes, you have no energy. So based on the fact that most of us are not getting 20 milligrams of iron from our diet, we should take 10 milligrams of elemental iron per day. We're seeing low iron in kids and men and the elderly. And when you don't have enough iron when you're old, you don't think straight. You can't remember things. You get brain fog. And so get tested. And we have a beautiful little green iron booklet that Celeste brought tonight that's on your chair. And I think it's on page 4 or 5. We give you the normal ranges for iron and where you should be. So it's another situation where you should know your number. But if you don't have enough iron, that's not a good thing. And yes, too much iron is also dangerous. And so if you've got that family genetic trait of super high iron, then get your iron checked. And if you have high iron, you give blood. One more question.
Yeah. I was just curious, like as a woman ages, her eyebrows start disappearing. And it's usually that outer third. What causes that? And first of all, thank you. I really think you're the best.
Okay.
You're so awesome. Thanks. Like really.
Thank you. Thank you so much. The reason why we lose the last third of our eyebrows is because we're developing low thyroid. So it's really important that when you get your cholesterol checked and your iron checked, that you also get your thyroid checked. And make sure you are below 2. Remember 2. 2 is a very important number. You want to be below 2. Otherwise, your eyebrows all fall out. And yes, if you have low thyroid, the number gets higher and higher and higher. So if you have a 6, a 7, an 8, 11, you're low thyroid. The other way is hyperthyroid. So, thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you so much from Nature's Fair Markets.